Pancreatic disorders. We're going to be talking about acute pancreatitis. Acute pancreatitis. Acute pancreatitis presents with severe mid-epigastric abdominal pain and tenderness. The key word here is tenderness. It's not just pain. It's tenderness. This pain is going to be worsened very much, increases very much when you press on this epigastric area. Also, there is going to be nausea and vomiting. And in severe cases, we can find Ranson's criteria. What are Ranson's criteria? Are there criteria to diagnose acute pancreatitis? No. These criteria will tell you that the acute pancreatitis you have is severe enough to warrant some surgical exploration. And this was the original Ranson's criteria purpose. Hypotension, leukocytosis, hyperglycemia, hypoxia, ARDS, metabolic acidosis, hemoconcentration, hypocalcemia due to fat malabsorption. When you find these criteria, these are indications of the severity of acute pancreatitis. Causes of acute pancreatitis. The most important two common causes of acute pancreatitis, alcohol and gallstones. Alcohol and gallstones. And which one is on the rise? Guess which one is on the rise? Too much alcohol or gallstones? And the answer is gallstones. Gallstones. The consumption of alcohol is kind of in the United States kind of steady or maybe even a little bit going down, but we have become more and more obese. And when we are obese, we have more and more cholesterol. And when we have more and more cholesterol, we have more tendency to form cholesterol gallstones. One of these stones can travel down and obstruct and block the common bile duct, and this will result in acute pancreatitis. Alcohol, gallstones, also trauma, abdominal trauma, infection, ERCP, and some medications can result in acute pancreatitis, but the commonest two causes are alcohol and gallstones. How to diagnose acute pancreatitis? Well, you suspect it by the abdominal pain, epigastric pain, and tenderness. Usually this pain radiates to the back. Usually this pain radiates to the back and is alleviated by leaning forward and is worsened by lying on the back. But the best initial test is amylase and lipase. Amylase and lipase are pancreatic enzymes. Amylase can come also from the salivary glands. That's why lipase is more specific. So lipase has higher specificity. But these enzymes do not tell severity. You can have one day high enzymes, the other day low enzymes, and still you have acute pancreatitis. The most accurate test to diagnose acute pancreatitis is abdominal CT scan. Abdominal CT scan is going to detect dilated common bile ducts, which could be because of some gallbladder stones. The most accurate test for acute pancreatitis is abdominal CT scan. MRCP, magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography. It is a very good tool to diagnose acute pancreatitis. It detects biliary and pancreatic duct obstruction that's not found on the CT scan. You can miss them on the CT scan, but you do not miss them in the MRCP. ERCP, endoscopic cholangiopancreatography, endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography. It detects stones or stricture in the duct system, and you can remove the stones or strictures. So ERCP is also not only diagnostic, but it is also therapeutic. But wait, you know what's the most common complication of ERCP? It is pancreatitis. Okay, is this confusing to you? So the most common complication of ERCP is pancreatitis. So if you do ERCP to a patient who does not have pancreatitis, this patient might develop pancreatitis as a complication of ERCP. That's why we no longer use ERCP to diagnose pancreatitis. We use it only to treat the already diagnosed pancreatitis. How do we diagnose pancreatitis? Lipases, amylases, abdominal CT, and most importantly, MRCP. So MRCP to diagnose, ERCP to treat. MRCP to diagnose, ERCP to treat acute pancreatitis. Treatment of acute pancreatitis, bowel rest, put a nasogastric tube, no feeding, bowel rest to take the secretions out, hydration, pain medications, it's a very painful condition. There is no specific medication to reverse pancreatitis. ERCP is therapeutic. ERCP is therapeutic. And when the CT shows more than 30% necrosis, take a biopsy, and we might need antibiotics as imipenem. If the biopsy showed infected necrotic pancreas, we can even do surgical debridement. For our case study, we have a 63-year-old African-American male who presents with intense left upper quadrant pain. And this pain is radiating to the back and under his left shoulder blade. For his social history, he has alcohol abuse with 1 to 12 cans of beer per day for 15 years. That's too much load of an alcohol. Question 6, identify 3 major risk factors for acute pancreatitis in these patients. What are the 3 major risk factors? Well, his age, the history of significant alcohol use, and hypertriglyceridemia. Hypertriglyceridemia. This can predispose also to stones, gallstones. Question 7, 2 abnormal lab findings that suggest that acute renal failure has developed in this patient. Because of the dehydration and the toxemia, we can have renal failure. How are we going to know that the kidney starts to fail when we see elevated BUN and elevated creatinine? Question 9, how many Ranson criteria does this patient have? Let me remind you, what are Ranson criteria? These are criteria for the severity of acute pancreatitis. And what is the probability that the patient will die from this attack of acute pancreatitis? Well, the patient has 6 Ranson criteria, and therefore the probability of death is approximately 40%. Ranson criteria points to the severity of the condition. It predicts, kind of predicts, the mortality risk in acute pancreatitis. The age, more than 55 years, white blood cell count, elevated white blood cell count, elevated blood glucose, elevated lactate dehydrogenase, and elevated AST, and elevated BUN. All these are positive Ranson criteria that point to the severity of acute pancreatitis in this patient.